It's been a hard winter. I mean, words mean a lot to me.
We always have to change things, you know. I mean, the cuisine we made 10 years ago, for my case at least, looks very little like the cuisine I do today.
Talking about raw is talking about ingredients, talking about the quality, talking about the relationship we have with the producer, the farmers, the hunters and the fishermen, and ask them the better product and pay the right price for this kind of products.
I think when you come to something totally, totally new, it's an exciting moment. But if all you have is these moments where you go from culture to culture to culture and you take things, and you do whatever comes into your mind, then you have no emotion, you have no connection to anything. So somehow you have to have a little bit of finding things in other places that's exciting, and a little bit of understanding history.
I've also adapted my dish because we went to the market, we saw some things. I also put the rose, the goritza, and also on the hill here we found wild plants on the hill. So of course, you know, once you see them, you taste the differences, and they're now on the plate.
Today we're going to kill the pig.
Everything we should do, except for cooking, was about blood. It's like killing a pig, eating charcuterie, and then we go hunting for a wild boar and everything. From a politically correct way of seeing it, how much energy does a pig use to convert the grains that it eats into to flesh protein? If everyone in China should eat as much meat as we do in Europe, there won't be anything to eat for the rest of the world. It was too much blood for me, and I even went a little pale this morning when I saw the poor pig getting killed. It was not really. I was thinking about stop eating pork after that, or meat, never.
I totally understand the reaction where you're like, "Wow, that's really disturbing," but it is disturbing. When I tell my cooks, like, if you raise that pig, or if you planted the seeds for that vegetable that you're cooking, and you saw someone else burning it or treating it with disrespect, you'd be quite upset. I think it is upon our job as cooks or chefs to do our best to represent that food, the farmer, the energy that went into it, to make it as delicious as possible, to cook with as much integrity as possible. You're not to really appreciate the food, but they can't really appreciate it unless they know the full cycle of life.
Thank you. plus difficile cuisiner l'hiver. Parce que j'ai un restaurant de thé. J'habite à Barcelone. Là, je regarde la cuisine d'une autre façon, non? Et aussi, écoute, aussi c'est difficile. Vraiment, c'est faire un dessert sans énergie.
Ouais, c'est compliqué. Hein.
C'est très complexe.
Kitchen downstairs, and we were just in our t-shirts and aprons and just screwing around, but it was fun. Like Massimo comes in, it was like, hey, what's up? You know, it was fun. When Pascal shows up, it was like friends, it was family, and we were in an environment that we were comfortable in. It was the kitchen.
In the United States, it really doesn't happen very often.
Never.
And normally it's a competition, but we go in, we cook, and there's, you know, in today's world, everything is, the media is very hyper, but for one night we go in and we just cook. And that's kind of beautiful.